How's it going, guys? Today we're going to be going over another $300 gaming PC build. This one is really interesting because we are actually able to get DDR4 RAM. Usually at this price point you end up getting like really old specs, but we actually got some like new stuff in here. A quick disclaimer, I will have links down below to all the parts that I used. They will be Amazon links, so they're not going to be priced at what I found them for. If you guys really want to get a good deal on them and build the PC for around the price I built it for, make sure you guys check out eBay and Facebook Marketplace. If you really want to save money, that's how you do it. Anyways, this gaming PC build will be broken down into three basic parts. First, we'll go over all the actual computer equipment and the prices that we got it all for. Then we'll briefly go over the actual building process and how it was in this case. And then lastly, we look at benchmarks, probably the best part, so you guys gotta stick around for that at least. And by the way, this is the winner of our last shout out. If you guys would like to get a shout out like this person, all you guys have to do is subscribe. I basically just choose a random subscriber every single time, so, and all you guys have to do is subscribe down below. All I do is just choose a random subscriber every single video to give a shout out to. Anyways, let's get into these PC parts. All right, so for the CPU, we have an i3-7100, and for the motherboard, we got an MSI B250M Pro. So I got both of these for only $100 altogether on Facebook Marketplace, which I felt like was a pretty fair price considering it is newer equipment and that the newer i3s will outperform an old i5. For the graphics card, we have a GTX EVGA 950, and we got that for $100 somehow during this GPU shortage. So for RAM, we spent $20 and we just got one single stick of 8 gig DDR4 RAM. So for the case, we went with the Aerocool case I recently reviewed. It's only like $47 right now. So if you guys are doing a build and looking to save a little, that's definitely one way you can. I do have a full review on that. So if you guys want to check that case out, I'll have that link in the description down below. So for the power supply, we got a 500 watt Aeras Gaming. I literally have no idea how to pronounce that, but yeah, the 500 watts, we paid like, what, $32, I think is a pretty good deal. For the storage, we went with another Kingston 240 gig M.2. Since we did have a newer motherboard, we could do that M.2 and get a lot faster storage. And for the operating system, we went with Windows 10 Home. And since the previous owner already owned Windows 10 Home, everything just activated as soon as I plugged in my USB with Windows 10, which you guys can get for free if you guys just go to the Microsoft website. If you think that your motherboard already had Windows 10 on it, then just do that. You'll save like a ton of money because then you don't have to pay the ridiculous price for Windows. So in regards of building for this case, it was a little difficult just because the top of this case is basically pinned up to the motherboard. So when you build, you just have to be careful to route that CPU wire before you screw it down because you're not gonna be able to get the connector through the back of it. There is a good amount of cable management in this case, but it's not as much as some cases. It's kind of just like a middle ground. It's not amazing, it's not awful. Bottom line, it just may take you a tiny bit longer to build in this case just because of how they laid this case out. Other than that, everything went pretty smoothly. We just installed Windows and we did all the drivers and we were able to start benchmarking. So for the benchmarks, we usually cover three games. We do Fortnite, Apex, and GTA. I think that's a pretty fair group of games to benchmark. So for Fortnite on high, we got 55 FPS. Medium, we got 120 FPS. Now, I will say that on high settings, I just go straight to high. You can adjust it a little to get to 60 FPS and keep some at high and maybe lower one at medium. Just really depends what you guys are looking for. So for Apex, we got 80 FPS on average. We did a very wide variety of settings. We have some high, we have some medium. Basically, I just chose the settings that would make this the most playable for this PC. So for GTA 5 on high, we got 90 FPS, and then at medium, we got 120 FPS. Now for a $300 build, I think these are pretty impressive numbers, and I bet you guys could even record gameplay with these things. Obviously, you'd have to adjust your settings to get the best frame rate possible, but after you do that, you guys should be able to record. So that is my $300 gaming PC build. I don't have a tutorial yet for building PCs, but it will be coming soon. It should actually be coming out after this, so make sure you guys go ahead and subscribe if you guys would like to get a building tutorial. Thank you guys so much for sticking around, and I hope you guys have a good one.